In this video, we're going to discuss air, specifically the compressed air from your shop compressor that feeds your machines. We're going to cover two things in this video, the volume of air in your shop and the quality of air in your shop. Now, air volume often gets confused with air pressure, but they are not the same thing. For example, imagine a machine shop with a single VF1. Now the mill uses a large volume of compressed air. Most of it goes to making tool changes. The tool changer uses the air to compress the heavy springs on the spindle drawbar to release the tool. So this shop has installed a compressor that matches the requirements in the pre-installation guide. The compressor has the correct volume of air for one machine and it maintains the correct air pressure. The pressure drops slightly as the machine cycles through a tool change but quickly builds back up. Now let's add a second VF1 to the shop floor. Logically, the shop owner adds another air line to his compressor manifold, and both machines now have air. Even when they're both powered up, each machine seems to have enough air pressure to run efficiently. But the gauges only show you the amount of air pressure in the system, not the volume. When that random moment comes and both machines make a tool change at the same time, each machine demands all the volume in the air tank. There's enough volume in there for one, but not for both. Now the pressure falls off and both machines alarm out. What's needed is a bigger air compressing system. The compressor pumps the air up to the correct pressure, but now there's enough air volume in the tank for two machines to make tool changes whenever they need to. If we were to add a third machine, we might want to upgrade the air compressor again to provide adequate volume for that additional machine. We publish a pre-installation guide for each machine that we sell. For the VF1, we recommend 4 standard cubic feet per minute, or SCFM, of air. We also suggest 3/8-inch diameter lines and fittings. Getting the right air volume to the machine is kind of a two-part equation. First, you need a big enough compressor to match the volume needs of all your machines. But second, you need large enough air lines to deliver that volume to each of them. Just as a compressor tank only holds so much volume, narrow air lines limit the amount of volume that can get through them. So we recommend 3/8-inch lines, but 1/2-inch diameter lines would be a great way to go, as these will give you more volume of air to each machine. Now let's talk about the quality of the air you're supplying. It should always be clean, dry air going to your machine. Water in your air lines is not just a nuisance, it can also cause serious damage to the machine. These solenoids here are especially vulnerable to contamination by both water and particulates. As you can see, your incoming air feeds directly into this manifold and right into these solenoids. Be sure and check this filter regularly, since this is the last line of defense before air is into your machine. Now, not only do you want to clean any debris out for obvious reasons, a clogged filter might also be restricting the airflow to your machine. Whether it's water or debris, poor air is a quick way to have your machine down and needing repairs. Of course, an air dryer is the best way to combat the problem of water in your air, but those aren't cheap. Luckily, there's another way to deal with this issue. When you plumb air to your machines, always use vertical risers with drains at the bottom and attach machine drops from the top of your main air supply line. Now any moisture in the system will tend to fall away from the path of the compressed air. This won't eliminate all moisture, but it will help a great deal. If you come across air-related issues on your machines, check to make sure you're providing clean, dry air at the proper pressure and the right volume. Your machines will run better and will live longer if you do. Thanks for watching.